Greetings, YouTube, and welcome to another episode of my playthrough of Ark Survival Evolved on the Acrimony server. My name is the Sarcasm Detector, and in today's episode, we are going to the Lava Island, and we're going to be exploring the two caves that are available there. It should be fairly easy, actually, so hopefully it won't take too much time. And we're going to be taking this pretty bird right behind us here. Ooh, all the lags. Pterodon named Pretty because, well, she's kind of good looking. Look at that booty. Once the lag clears, this area is a little bit laggy because of all the dinos and stuff. So let's not waste any time at all. Or any lag at all. Oh, someone's buzzing by. Once we get past all these buildings here, the lag should clear up. And on the last episode, it was very, very foggy, so you did not get to see any of this up ahead of us. But now we seem to have a clear day. And this island ahead of us is the North Tropical Island. That's the jungle islands there. Back there in the distance is Skull Island. We're going to save that for a different episode. But that's the South Tropical Island there behind us where we have most of our bases. Up ahead of us beyond the North Tropical Island is the Half Burnt Island, which is basically the new Dead Island, the new Carno Island. On this island here, the North Tropical, there are a couple of tribes that have a big bases here, and as you can see from the lag, we're just getting over one right now. Where'd the base go? Oh, there it is. Have quite a few dragons already and a stargate. There's another tribe on the island also, but let's just keep going forward, focus on the mission. This here in front of us, again, is Half Burnt Island, which plays exactly like Carno Island, the northeast island on the vanilla map. You can see Argents, Raptors, Scorpions, Carnos, T-Rexes, and the occasional wild dragon. So let me actually, I saw a wild dragon on the island a little bit earlier, so I'm just going to get as high as possible, because really I don't want to mess with a wild dragon. Not on a Pterodon. I can hear him. There he is. Okay. And this here, in front of us, is the Lava Island, which is also similar to Carno Island. It just has more Dimetrodons, Giganos, more T-Rexes, Spinos, that sort of thing. It's a Carno here. Anything dangerous around the entrance? So this here is the Eastern Lava Cave, and some people say this is one of the most dangerous caves on the center map. Gonna actually have to walk in. Nothing's chasing me, that's good. But if you have a flyer, gotta poop there for a second. If you have a flyer enabled, if you're on an unofficial server like this one here, it is ridiculously easy. We're just gonna fly in, grab the artifacts, and head straight back out. Nothing's chasing us, so good, good. On official servers, you can't exactly do this. It does become quite a bit dangerous. Here's the drop-off. Down into the mouth of hell we go. There are two artifacts in the cave. Oh, look at these guys all clumped up. We're just gonna fly right past you guys, if you don't mind. And have I commented how much I love the center map? It just looks absolutely fantastic. All these, I mean, I think the caves in the center map are significantly better done. They're a lot better done than the original caves from the original map. What's in here? Don't have the layout exactly memorized. There's quite a few bugs. Ooh, crystal and obsidian. I need some obsidian. I'm running low. But I would rather not mess with the bugs. Look at all this. What's in here? Oh. Okay, I'm just being careful because I've said before I do not like to fly over open lava. Generally, bad things happen to me when I do that. So, here we are, and that is the artifact. Just gonna take a quick look around. Are there any loot things? No, just a lot of resources in here. A little bit of frame rate there. That's land. Nothing is aggro to me, so let's go ahead and pick this guy up. And we'll put him on the bird. And I'm just gonna wait for this to respawn again. It should be only a couple of minutes. I'll grab the second version and we'll head towards the second artifact. Which artifact did we get this time? Artifact of the Massive. So I'll bring you guys back as soon as I grab the second artifact. Alrighty, so let's head off to the next artifact in the cave. And that one should be just as easy. I wonder if there's a shortcut we can take. I think there is. Maybe not. Not through there, anyways. It is possible to bring some of the bigger dinos down here. Only issue is you won't be able to get them back out. Nice. Although, if you have a Stargate... Huh. Now that makes me wonder. If it'll let us build a Stargate at the entrance of the cave. We do have cave building disabled, even though we have cave flying enabled. So we're gonna have to find out if we can actually build a Stargate on the entrance of the cave, at the big drop there. And see if we can bring some of the bigger dinos, like a T-Rex. T-Rex will be fantastic in here. Heck, even a saber tooth or a few saber teeth. I wonder, is the plural of saber tooth saber teeth? Or is it just saber tooths? Saber tooths. I don't know. Okay, I think we're heading the right direction. Yeah. So I am wearing clothes, just regular cloth armor. I just want to check what's here. And I have pretty high fortitude. I think my fortitude is at 66, 68 something. What's the temperature here? 47 degrees. So yeah, I'm not even breaking a sweat. I think a ghillie suit would actually be a lot better in here. Especially if you don't have as high fortitude. Anything around that will cause me issues? It doesn't look like it. Artifact of the Strong. That is one of the newer ones, I believe. So again, I'm just going to wait for the second artifact to spawn in, and I'll bring you back in when we're ready to go. All right, and off we go. So that is the Eastern Lava Cave. According to the wiki, one of the more difficult caves in the map. Just goes to show, if you have a flyer, it makes things a lot easier. Significantly. Now, I think by default, when this map, the center, was a mod, flying was enabled. And I think there are still a couple of areas where you can still fly. I think the cave in the center proper, the floating island at the actual center of the map, that you can still fly. Of course, there's the underworld. But yeah, these caves were meant for flying. And oh, glitch. Well, that just makes things a lot easier. I got glitch teleported out. All right. Easy enough. So again, let me actually show you. Let me head back there and show you where it is on the map. Let me pull out my GPS unit. It's at the east of the island. There's there's two volcano calderas here. So the eastern one right there. So let me just stop flying for a sec. There's no gigas around. Okay. 27 by 65 approximately. Now time to head to the Western Lava Cave. Now it's only called the Western Lava Cave because it happens to be here on Lava Island. There's actually no lava in the Western Lava Cave. There's actually quite a bit of water. Just keeping my eye out. So here we have the Red Obelisk. And that area ahead of me here, I really like this area. I am planning on building something absolutely humongous here, a really big base. I haven't exactly decided what it's going to be yet, but there's a huge area of absolutely flat ground. And you know how flat ground on Ark is a premium. So it's a very, very good area for building a base. You don't actually have to do the whole thing of building on pillars and ceilings and elevating and just trying to get things flat. You can just build regular foundations. So here is the cave. It's just across this lava flow, and I already prepared by getting one of my rafts here. And it is right here. I don't know if you can get a flyer in here. I don't know, it looks a little bit tight. Is anything dangerous? Just a quick look around. 32.5, 44.4 approximately. Now, normally I just park my bird on the raft. Oh, wow, okay. You can get a bird in. I don't know if I will, because there are some swimming parts. So I'll just follow the plan. I'm just gonna just take a look around here because I'm gonna have to jump off and run for it. Anything really absolutely dangerous like a T-Rex, Giga, Raptors, anything? The coast looks clear. All right. Sit tight. Does this thing have an inventory that I can put stuff in? No, it doesn't. Okay. That carno makes me nervous. Now, there is a way I love to do these caves, and it involves grappling hooks and rocket launchers. So this is going to be spectacularly explosive. Just put my assault, just in case. Really, I think a shotgun would be better. Oh boy. Let me gather some stem. And I can hear the creepy crawlies already. Fill up on water. Let's take a look around. Doesn't look like there's anything dangerous immediately apparent. So we're just gonna go this way first. Metal, silica pearls, crystals, and I think this is the way here. Some fungus, lots of pretty flowers, and some jumping involved. I'm just lazy. I believe you can actually get raptors in here, and raptors are pretty good for this portion. Yeah, I know I can probably just run and jump, but it's a bit more fun. Oh, rubber band. Keep going. Oh, look at that. Hey, guys. Yeah, this is a very expensive way to deal with this. The artifact is right there, and we do have a loot crate. I have on occasion accidentally blown myself up doing this, by the way. Always use a lot of caution when playing with rocket launchers. Kaboom, yeah. Guess that one's already dead. I think there's one over here behind the metal. Scorpion. Oh, I missed him. I'm gonna have to aim a little bit higher. Maybe here. There we go, we got a couple of things. Anything else dangerous in the area? Let's quickly grab the loot crate. Journeyman cloth. Artifact of the pack. Oh, we can't do it from while under the water? What the? That's not good. And there's still a spider there. Oh, it might be a distance thing. So like I was saying earlier, it is possible to bring like raptors and terror birds. I think terror birds would actually be fantastic for this particular area to get that particular artifact. The next one, it's a little bit more difficult because there is a underwater portion. What am I stuck on? A twig. Something attacking me? How many grappling hooks do I have left? 8. Now, another good tactic to use here would be to just speed through it, like buff your movement speed to ridiculous numbers, and you can just. Ooh, that was close. You can just plow through here as fast as possible. And hopefully not running over cliffs like I almost did. So this is the water part here. Still nothing dangerous. I think we have to move up a little bit further, but I just want to see what's up here. Wait, did I put on the wrong gloves? All this lag. Yeah, my Mastercraft cloth is better. quick run around. Doesn't seem to be anything here, which is good news for me. And I believe that is the artifact, and I do see something moving. Interesting. Journeyman hide pants. Artifact of the hunter. All right, let's decamp this as quickly as possible. Strange that there was no guardians. Usually there's more spiders and scorpions and all those nasty creepy crawlies. But, seems we lucked out this time. Ooh, oh. And had a fairly smooth run through both of the caves. We're not scot-free yet. Get some stamina back, okay. Probably did not need the scuba gear for this short little swim. I think the flippers would have been fine. Almost there. That's not good. He's on the other side, though. Looks like we're good. Oh. Run, scorpion, T-Rex, shenanigans. Come on, get on the boat. Oh, really? T-Rex didn't notice us, scorpion sure did. But that is it. The two caves of Lava Island. Maybe done a little bit cheaty. Well, at least the first one. So I hope you guys enjoyed this particular video. We'll be coming back with more episodes very, very soon. For the moment, I'm just going to head back home and park these artifacts where they belong. If you like this video, be sure to hit the like button. If you haven't subscribed already, what are you waiting for? Subscribe right meow. Right meow. And remember to tell all your friends about it. This is the Sarcasm Detector saying goodnight.